We are still in the past tense. Past of waqara, qara'a, waqara, 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 waqara. Waqara is empty spot. Something was there. You take away and leave it empty. وتركها وقرا. He left it empty spot. وقرا. وقرا قف. وكذا. 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 وكذا is to smack somebody in the ear. وكذا. As Allah say about Musa, فَوَكَذَّهُ مُوسَى فَقَدَى عَلَيْهِ وَكَذَا وَكَذَا. And here, وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ وَقَرٌ. وَقَرٌ in Surah Fusilat. وَقَرٌ, they will call وَقَرٌ as deaf, the ear is empty. Because the hearing spot is out, is broken, cannot hear. They call that also وَقَرٌ. وَقَرٌ. Wakaza, that's to smack somebody. Wakaza, wakaza. Qasama, 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 to divide things. You buy something for your wives. You divide it and give each person what they're supposed to have. Qasam. So they call this also qasamun bainahum layalihim. To share the nights between them. All this is a qasam. Qasama, something you divide between people. And this same qasama, it will come as a swear. To say, wallahi, uqsim billah. Allah says, la uqsim. Uqsim. Qasama is to swear. Qasama. But it depends what word it come with that will tell you if it's sway or is to divide something. If he say qasama bainahum, that means he divides something between people. But if he say qasama billah, innahu al-haq, he swear by Allah, that is true. When you put Allah with a qasama billah, he swear by Allah, then that will consider is swear. Qasama, qasama, qasama. Qasama. This qasama is a measurement. You measure from this wall to here. And no, it's 3 meters and 5 inches. That called qasama. He measure it. Measurement. Measurement. Qasama. Nadara. Nadara. He looked. If you would say, look at it, you say, unduru. Unduru. Nadara, he look. Nadara, he look. Nadara, they sound same, but they're different. Nadara, nadara, zo and tha. Nadara, this nadara is look, as with your eyes. Nadara, this is the vowel, or the earth. Someone, It's happening a lot back home. People not know the deen. You sick, or your wife sick, or your mother, or your kid sick. You said, if my kids get well, I will slaughter cow and give sadaq. This is nadhar. Or you said, my son is in the way going to Europe. If he arrive in peace, I will pray 1,000 rakat to Allah. This is nadhar. You have to do it. It's not good to do this, but if you say so, you have to complete it. You make sure you fulfill it. The Prophet said, do not do it, alayhi salatu wasalam, because it's a miserness to worship Allah. It's like, oh Allah, I'm not going to worship you 1,000 rakat unless you do such thing for me. Which either Allah do that for you or not, you're supposed to be obeying Allah, pleasing Allah. But you put a condition, in order for you to pray 1,000 rakat, If you get healthy out of this sickness, or your son is on the way going to Europe, when he arrives in peace, you will do such thing. What type of ibadah that will be? It could be, I will give $10 away for sake of Allah, or I will kill chicken, or I'm going to kill a camel. It's no joke. When you say it, the joke and the real is the same. If you say such thing, you name something that you will do, you make sure you do it. If you don't do it, you die with that, you die with the obligation of Allah. It's bad. So that is nadr, oath. So you oath for something, you have to fulfill it. That is nadr. And nadhara, that is looking. Watara, we call salatul witr, the third number, not two. The shafi'i is two. Anything is two is a shafi'i. Heaven and the earth, right and the left, east and the west, south and the north, male and female, short and tall, ugly and nice, everything is two. So Allah is with them. It's no comparing and no pardon, no patriot to him. So what are all? So things that are only one is with them. Only one is with them. That's why in the hadith, Allah said, "Inna Allah." The Prophet ﷺ said, "Inna Allah witrun yuhibbul witr." Allah is earth, he loves the earth. Meaning night prayer, last prayer you should do to make one prayer, one rakat, Allah loves it. Because he's only one. He loves that one to be in his obedience. Daytime we have witr. Last prayer of the daytime is a witr. Maghrib is three rakat. It doesn't have four. Fajr is the beginning. Two rakat is even number. Four rakat of dhuhr is even number. Four rakat of asr is even number. The last rakat of the day is maghrib. It's three rakat. It's odd number. Because it's not even. It's three. It doesn't have four. So that's why when we pray night, night prayer is only Isha. So we end that also. When we pray two rakat. After that, we pray one rakat. Or we put those two rakat together, three rakat together, like maghrib, but we will not sit in between them to do tashahud. You just pray all the three rakat without doing tashahud. To the last one, the end, you do the tashahud and make a taslim. So that is witr. Witr is odd, it's not even. Anything witr, it means anything odd. It's not even number. Watara, now those two are similar. Witr and watara. Watara is a woman who her husband divorced her. She's a divorced woman. That is watara. As in Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah said about Zayd, فَلَمَّا قَدَى زَيْدٌ مِّنْهَا وَطَرَى زَوَّجْنَاكَهَا. When Zayd divorced Zaynab bint Jahsh, Allah said, we made you to marry her. So the Prophet married Zaynab bint Jahsh after the Zayd ibn Harith divorced her. That's watara. When they say watara is a woman that is divorced. إِنَّهَا watara, she is divorced, meaning her husband let her go. Not now these women saying, I'm through, I'm moving on. They divorce you, you don't divorce them. Nasara is the help. We say, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ, help of Allah. When the help of Allah comes, Nasara, he helped. He helped. وَقَرَ وَكَزَ قَصَمَ قَصَمَ نَظُرَ نَذَرَ وَتَرَ وَطُرَ نَصُرَ وَقَرَ وَكَزَ قَصَمَ قَصَمَ نَظَرَ نَذَرَ وَتَرَ وَطُرَ نَصُرَ وَقَرَ وَكَزَ قَصَمَ قَصَمَ نَظَرَ نَذَرَ وَتَرَ وَطُرَ نَصَرَ وَقَرَ وَكَزَ قَصَمَ قَصَمَ نَظَرَ نَظَرَ وَتَرَ وَطُرَ نَصَرَ وَقَرَ وَكَزَ قَصَمَ قَصَمَ نَظَرَ نَظَرَ وَتَرَ وترى نصره.